section 2. So several quotes here. The guided sales process, the top quote, understand the business owners aren't really looking for visitors to their websites. They are looking for qualified leads to be generated by visits to the website. Too often we hear business owners boasting about the traffic to their websites when they should be tracking how many visitors converted to contacts. This conversion is the goal. The next one, the low-risk offer takes many forms. Webinars, webcasts, or popular ways to invite prospects to connect with your company. Free consultations, demos, assessments, reviews, free evaluation of your company's energy uses or how ABC Energy can suggest savings, all work nicely as well. That one, I knew you got, knew either Mark or you were coming, so I knew that ran into your business, wanted to make sure we call out that as an example. The next page, about halfway down, understanding the marketing machine is attracting all sorts of new people to your company. Some are qualified, but most are not. This gets into what I was just talking about. Think of a deep sea fishing trip. Your goal is to catch 10 big fish. You throw out your net and catch a few big fish, but lots of little fish end up in the net as well. You throw the little fish back and keep the big ones. However, in order to catch those 10 beauties, you might have to catch 100 of the little ones too. It's the same with marketing. So it's still that numbers game, Christian, you referred to, but it's done automated through marketing versus taking up the time and interruptive sales approaches. It's the same with marketing. Assuming your close rate is 50%, you need 20 good opportunities, quotes, proposals, presentations, to get to 10 of your clients. In order to get those 20 good opportunities, you might need to attract 60 to 100 contacts, both qualified and unqualified. If you don't have enough opportunities at the top of the sales funnel, you will never get to the target number of clients to fall out at the bottom. And it's a big difference between finding those people by offering something that they're looking, searching for now, versus a broad net that you're just throwing and interrupting people. So you need to refine it by doing a more effective process, but then you're allowing your automation through that process for them to kind of select themselves to be a qualified client where you spend the most of your energy. Find a more remarkable title for your sales guys. People have a preconceived notion that all sales representatives. Remove that from their equation by creating a more relevant title for your sales people. Data center engineers bring experience, respect, and knowledge to the table. Solar specialists offer ideas, support, and guidance on challenging decisions. IT advisors help small businesses navigate complicated IT issues. Sales representatives just sell things. Two down from there in the note. Note, make sure your definition of opportunities is accurate. Many companies calculate the close rate by using the total amount of contacts, whether qualified or not. Remember, potential new clients or customers move through a sales process in four stages. Contact, suspect, prospect, and opportunity. It's only the final stage, opportunity, that should be included in your conversion rate calculation, because they are the only group that has gone through the complete sales or complete process. If prospects or suspects drop out along the way, we can assume they weren't really qualified to begin with. That's a good thing. There is no need to count these unqualified leads in the conversion rate calculation. Only qualified prospects who have gone through the entire sales process count as opportunities. And right below that, so here's an example, just to get you thinking. 100 contacts generated in 1 month, 95 agreed to a discovery call, 65 qualified and moved to a diagnosis stage, 55 diagnosed, but only 40 agreed to move to the design stage, 40 opportunities, display, I don't know what that is in brackets there, that's the stage of the 5D process, I guess. And then 15 new clients. 15 new clients divided by 40 opportunities equals 37.5% conversion rate. Close. Second one now. By positioning your business as a trusted advisor and proactive resource, you can bet that when your clients have a pain, you'll be the first one they come to for a solution. What's more, by taking this approach, you raise your prices. Why? Because as your business moves away from a purely, this is what we were talking about, purely transactional customer relationships, and exchanges towards a more consultative offering, the value of your service increases in direct response. Any final thoughts? I do need to run because I've got some.
I have one thought in summary.
VP's waiting for me to facilitate a meeting, so.
Real quick, in summary, I feel like all the points in the book, like, whether or not, like, I think the one point about flats out and hitting that is probably the metric that can be used to determine if we're not doing all these things, right? Because we've done it, we grew that to a point where we had this recurring revenue model number we wanted to get to, and it was probably a freaking six months to a year, we just could not get over that number. Like, why can't I get past that freaking number? get a new client. How are we still at that number? And then it wasn't until we really started to figure out how to tell the right stories and be remarkable and disqualify bad clients and not waste time. And then we were able to just blow through it. But it wasn't until, if we would have, you know, I think that's the metric. If you're at a plateau, then you need to take a hard look at whether or not you're doing these things. Because once you start doing